what I wanna, innovate what I'm gonna. You can hate all you wanna, but you're still in your pajama. Now I ain't a prima donna, but I built what I wanna. You can say my vision's wrong, the tune of my song. Broke my thumb,
banging to my own drum.
Broke my thumb,
banging to my own drum. Broke my thumb, banging to my own drum.
Hootin' and clapping, boots I am a strapping. A click, click, clacking.
Hurrah! Bootstrapping in America. Yeah, bootstrapping in America.
Thomas, we are back, my friend.
We are. We have the youngest bootstrapper in the house ever. This is our Bootstrapping in America segment. I'm Tom Sosnoff. He's Tony Batista. We got, look at you, Oliver, Leopold. How are you doing, man?
I'm good.
Look at that kid. The kid's all dressed up.
He's Oliver, ready. You are dressed for success. I am sorry that my friend does not do the same.
All right, let's get a few details here. You are 10.
Yes.
You're in what grade?
Fourth grade.
And you go to school in a suburb of Chicago, right?
Mm-hmm.
In Evanston. So let's get started. First of all, when did you get interested in the markets?
Well, it was one day at the bank where I was depositing money, and I saw an advertisement that said invest with Chase Bank. So I asked a bunch of questions, and then we went to the library.
Who went to the library? You and your mom?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that was about 2 years ago.
So you were 8?
Yeah.
You know, Tony, well, I won't talk about Tony. When I was 8 or 9 years old, because I'm going to tell you a little story. Me and my buddies, and this is back in the day when we could get on a bus, when our parents would let us go wherever. We would get on a bus and we'd go to the nearest town, which is about 15 minutes away. And we'd go from bank to bank and we'd try to collect silver coins. And we were about 9 years old. And the reason we would collect silver coins is because they had just stopped making them. And we had $20 was our bankroll. We would go from bank to bank and get all these rolls of, you know, dimes
quarters,
or whatever it is.
Dimes.
Well, mostly dimes. And then just take out the silver ones and go to the next bank. And people would be like, we walk in the banks, people would be like, oh, God, you kids. Okay. That was my first thing investing. And it was the same kind of thing, just going from bank to bank. So you're 8 years old. You walk in the bank and you went to the library and you got all excited about investing. What was the next step?
Well, at home, we found a website where you invest with fake money. So I started there.
Really? Okay.
And then I got interested in doing it for real.
So when did you make your first real investment?
Probably when I was like 9.
9. So you used one of your, like, you know, your mom's, your dad's, or somebody's account, right? Mm-hmm. And what'd you do?
Well, the first thing I did was researched because I wanted a good stock.
Okay.
And I found Abbott Laboratories, and our family invests in Abbott a lot. So my parents gave me 2 shares just as a start.
They kickstarted you.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. So they gave you 2 shares of Abbott. What is, Tony, throw Abbott up on the chart.
Abbott's trading around $65.
Okay. So this is a great way to start. So do you remember where you first got Abbott? When you got Abbott, do you remember what the stock price was?
It was around 50 or 60.
50 or 60. Okay. So let's say it's like mid-50. We'll go $55 or something. So they gave you 2 shares of stock. It's $55. Now, what'd you do with it?
What'd you do with it?
I like that.
You kept it. Do you still have it today?
Yeah. And now I have 10 shares.
How do you have 10 shares?
For the holidays, they'll give me stocks. And yesterday, I got 4 shares of Disney.
Wow. You got 4 shares. Was that your Christmas present?
That was my Christmas present from my grandpa, one of them. Yeah.
See, now that's cool. This is what you should be doing. Just take a lesson, okay?
So, I'm trying. I'm doing
so your grandpa gave you 4 shares of Disney.
Yeah, and I wanted it because they just bought Star Wars, and I thought it would go up.
Yeah. So did you ask your grandpa for 4 shares of Disney, or did he just give it to you?
Well, I told my mom, so my mom told all the grandparents, and then my grandpa volunteered to get it.
Okay, so most kids ask for, like, Like, my kids are in their 20s, okay? And they
Isn't
ask,
there, like, a Beanie Baby you can play with or something like that? I mean...
Do your friends think you're weird because you like the stock
market? Power Rangers or something?
They do? Mm-hmm. They think you're weird, right? They mm-hmm. say, what are you doing? And, see, my friends used to think I was weird for the same kind of reason. You're
Tom, friend. I consider you...
You didn't have any friends.
I consider myself your friend, and I know you're weird, so it's okay.
But I used to think the same way. And I got my first share of stock from my uncle when I was about 10 years old, and it was gave me a share of American Telegraph. They're out of business. And AT&T. One share. No, it wasn't AT&T. It was American Telegraph or something else. Mm-hmm. And he gave me one share of IBM. He gave me one share of two. I lost the share of IBM, but I got the, which was like maybe $60 at the time. And I the other one went out of business.
Butchered it.
Yeah.
But now you must like math or something like that.
I really like math.
The stock symbols aren't that aren't that fun to look at. So you do like math. You must have some sort of interest in math. So that's good.
But the reason you're on here today is a bootstrapper. Okay, do you know what bootstrappers mean? Kind of.
No.
It's kind of like when you start your own business. You do it like.
Oh yeah.
You know, it's like you start with nothing and you kind of build up your own business. I mean, most kids your age. I'm not even saying most kids. Like, what was the first job you ever had, Tony? Legal job.
Newspaper route.
Newspaper.
Yeah.
Most kids, newspaper route.
They don't do newspaper routes anymore.
Yeah, I wanted to do that to earn money, but they don't do it anymore.
It's obsolete.
Because it's obsolete because most of the stuff's on the internet.
Right.
Yeah.
So I heard the story. We actually read about you in the Wall Street Journal.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why we called you up, because you're local here in Chicago, and the Wall Street Journal did a whole story on you, which is kind of interesting because otherwise we never would have found out about you, which is cool. And then, but you actually write a newsletter.
Yeah.
Let's hear about it.
So.
I got it here, Bat.
It's called the Investment Times, right?
Yeah,
Oliver?
It started in
Promote the, yourself, son. This
it
is,
started in the summer where it was like no template. It was just like. I would do stories or the top Dow in the last 10 years or the bottom. But then the next one, I did a format and a template, and I was getting excited. So then I added things like a website, and it's really grown.
Okay, so do you know what a future is? Like you trade mm-hmm. futures and stuff? You know, you can do that like on... Mm-hmm. I want to buy your future and sell his future. Okay. Nothing personal, all right? Because this is actually very well written. I got it right here, Bat. I'm going to throw it up here.
Mm-hmm.
We could actually throw it. You could throw the site up there.
Yep.
What's the website?
It's theinvestmenttimes.webs.com.
Theinvestmenttimes.webs with an S?
Mm-hmm.
.webs.com.
Very cool.
We'll put it up. We'll throw it up there. Mm-hmm. So this is actually very well written. It's articulate.
You.
It's got a bunch of pages. So talk to us. What do you like here?
I like just writing and writing what I like.
Yeah. Like what kind of stocks did you write about in the last newsletter?
In that one, I talked about Apple entering the bear market because it was during that Halloween time where it wasn't doing very well. And
do you remember the crash of 87? Just kidding. Because if you did, then I'd be really freaked out. So you talked about when Apple sold off a little bit, you mean?
Mm-hmm.
When it went from, let's say, 700 to like 550.
Yeah.
Did you ever buy Apple yet?
I have Apple. I got it around like 450.
Can I have it?
Would you buy one share at 450?
Yeah.
Very cool. What's the game plan for you right now? Like how big is your portfolio? How many different stocks do you have?
I have, I think, around seven different stocks.
Seven different stocks. Wow. And your biggest holding is Abbott Labs?
Well, Abbott Labs and New England Realty, I have 10 of each. New England Realty is my grandpa's company, so he gave each cousin 10 shares.
Oh, very nice. And let's talk a little bit about, have you seen our show, Chasing Warren?
I saw it up when...
Yeah,
we
when
were
we
were back
playing.
There, yeah.
Well, that's about, it stars a bunch of 12-year-olds, and they're all learning about investing. So you should definitely check out our Chasing Warren show. Even Tony has a cameo appearance in there, and same with me. But you should watch it because it's about a group of 12-year-olds that are starting. Mm-hmm. You are in Fourth grade?
Yeah.
How do you like that fourth grade?
I like fourth grade. It's fun.
Now, I got a question for Albert. You, obviously, you go to school. You must be off this week, right? I mean, you're not playing hooky or anything like that. I don't want to start you on the bad road or anything like that, right? You're not playing hooky, right? Okay. Now, you designed the website yourself?
Yeah.
So you know how to code and stuff like that? Like, I mean, you...
Well...
It's like a box kit, Tony.
Is that what it is?
It was this website where you can make a website for free when I save enough money. I'm going to, like, get my domain name. But it's basically drag and drop. I set up PayPal.
That's awesome. That's very, very good. I'm surprised you can do that because when I was 10 years old, I know I wasn't doing it. So I was painting fire hydrants. That's what I was really
It's called
doing.
Graffiti. Shh. We're just having some fun. Hey, you know what, Oliver? This was great to meet you. And, you know, it's very exciting. We have this, we're on this kick about financial literacy for younger, you know, we feel like if you start when you're 10 or 12, whatever it is, or 8 or 16, that kids are going to be so much better prepared for everything else in life, you know, from college all the way through to the end, that you are truly going to be an inspiration. Although it may not seem like it now, and other kids may go, that's weird at this point. I understand, but you're going to be an inspiration and it's really exciting to see. And I'm going to look back at this little interview that we did, and you're going to come back on the show when you're like 16, and you're going to go, that wasn't me.
That's right.
I can't believe I did that when I was, you know, when I was 10. But it's great to meet you and to talk to you, and we're excited that we had you here.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks, Oliver. Good luck with your website. Webs.com. Very good. Thank you, Leopold. Appreciate it. We'll be back in 90 seconds. You're listening to Get Tasty on the Taste Trade Network.